السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome to another program from the Gems of the Heart, where we look into our hearts and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify it for us, this magnificent and amazing creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants our hearts to be purely for Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one that created us, He's the one that created this heart, and He made this heart the place of faith, the place of wisdom, the place of all goodness, that it shows in our speech and actions what we have in our hearts. And no one will enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unless they have a sound heart. وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Ibrahim alayhi salam making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to disgrace him in the day of resurrection, when there is no wealth nor offsprings will avail and benefit the person except for those who come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a sound heart. So this is our job on the face of earth, is to purify our hearts, to make our hearts sound, purifying it from anything that would makes it disease or ill or whatever, things that negates the purity of it, with shirk, associating partners with Allah, envy, hatred, whatever there is, arrogance, showing off, and to adorn this heart with all kinds of good things, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the fear of Allah, the hope for the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so on. Actions that has to be done. This heart has to do certain actions of ubudiyyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the same way with the speech and actions, and also actions to remove all kinds of evil things from our hearts. And the most important thing and the foundation for all of this is the proper belief. Matters of aqidah, the matters of belief, have to be sound and strong foundation, that everything else is built over the strong foundation of the matters of belief. And that's why the matters of aqidah has to be always repeated. We have to purify our hearts from any distorted or any deviant belief. And as we heard before many times, it's one thing to be guided to be among the people of Al-Islam, to be guided to the deen of Al-Islam. And also within the deen of Al-Islam, a person needs guidance to be on the way of the people of Ahlul Sunnah and Jama'ah, to be guided with our speech and actions and our belief and so on, in every breath we take in this life, to be constantly guided. And that's why also, as we heard before, the Qur'an is the book of Aqeedah, is the book of creed, is the book of guidance, the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. But for example, the ulama, they wrote books of Aqeedah, even though the Quran is the best book of Aqeedah. Why is that? As the ulama, they say, to make dhabt of the Aqeedah, to perfect our belief, to make sure that we are on the straight path, because deviation happened in this Ummah. And this Ummah, the Prophet ﷺ, split into many different sects, as the Prophet ﷺ said. And people innovated things in matters of Aqidah and others. And that's why we have to go back to how things were at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, as-salaf al-salih, the early generations of Islam, to make sure that our belief is according to their belief. And this is the most important thing to purify our hearts with. And then we build over this with matters of actions and good deeds and so on and so forth. And that's why we're looking into the entire religion of Al-Islam one step after another, to see how can we look at it from the perspective of the heart, and how to purify our hearts from this perspective. And we're still in the first pillar of Al-Iman, which is to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we talked about the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in lordship, and the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the ubudiyyah, the only one to be worshipped, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the the main thing of purifying the hearts from anything that is attached to other than Allah. And we've been talking in many episodes about the beautiful names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that how this is the source of purification of our souls and our hearts, to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His names and attributes. And the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a matter of ghaib, it's unseen to us, and something that we have to be very clear on it. And the people of knowledge, and if you look into the books of Aqidah, and Ibn Qudama, and Lum'at al-I'tiqad, and others, when they made it very clear that if all the entire humanity get together, all of their uqul, all of their intellect and reason would get together to try to find out about the unseen, they would not be able to, because it's unseen. It's a very obvious thing. But miserably, many of the human beings, they talk about the unseen as if it's a seen matter for them. How can they say anything about the unseen when it's unseen? And this is how the human beings, they, you know, tend to be sometimes fooled by their own reason and intellect, which is only limited to what they see with their own eyes. So they take what they see with their own eyes as an evidence of what's present in the unseen, and that's not necessarily true. So they would try to explain the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to their reason. The names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a matter of unseen to us, to know the attributes of Allah. So the only way that we get to know the unseen, the ghaib, is by the wahi, revelation from Allah, the Quran and the authentic sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. The names, the attributes, the meanings of the names and the attributes and what it means and how to believe in it, all of this is from the wahi, revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why over and over again we don't deny anything that is mentioned in the Quran or the authentic sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We don't distort the meanings of it, we don't alter the meaning of it, we don't make any similarities when it comes to the attributes of Allah to the attributes of the human beings, for example, because nothing is the like of Allah, and He's the All-Hearer, the All-Seer subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we believe in it the way it is. How these attributes are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, because we don't have the knowledge of it. It's a matter of unseen to us, but we know the meanings of it, because the Quran has been revealed in the clear Arabic language in a clear way. So as is mentioned before, the proper belief in the names and attributes of Allah, and then we try to benefit from these names and attributes, so that we really become steadfast on the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of these names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is mentioned in the Quran six times in the word Al-Qahhaar, the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Qahhaar. And Al-Qahhaar is mentioned like this in the Quran six times, and two times Al-Qahir, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Qahir, and the same meaning with slight differences between both. But what it means really, as they translate it usually, the subjugator, the one that is prevailing over all things. Nobody can defeat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everybody's defeated under the power of Allah. It's a word that can give some negative meanings for those who do not understand it, or if they're talking about a human being, right? When you oppress someone, when you subjugate someone to your own will, from a human being to a human being, that's not a pleasant thing. Human beings, they don't like that, because they're alike, human beings. But when it comes to the creator of the heavens and the earth, nobody can be against the sovereignty and the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everybody is under the power of Allah. And that's a great meaning for the believers, to humble themselves to Allah. One of the major problems for human beings, as it's mentioned before also, is arrogance. Human beings, they have this arrogance in them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above all. Nothing happens without the permission of Allah. The disbelief of the disbelievers happen by the permission of Allah. The injustices, the evil actions happen by the permission of Allah. Not the permission of Allah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved for them to do this and He's pleased with them, but it's the universal permission of Allah, because He's the creator of all things. Nothing would happen without Him allowing it to happen, because everything is under the sovereignty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, the rububiyyah and the lordship then becomes deficient, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most perfect. But why would He allow something like that to happen? He's the most wise. And that's why the believers, they rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most wise, He's the all-knower. There are great reasons and great benefits as a result of that, and that is for the people to be patient, to struggle, for the people of the truth to be firm and steadfast when they faced with all kinds of oppression or difficulties and so on. And part of which is that they know if there is oppression on the face of earth, if there are people subjugating others to humiliation and so on, they should remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Qahhaar. He is the one that is over everyone, and He is the subjugator, and He is the one that He prevails over everyone. But things are delayed for a reason, for people to be content and to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He is the All-Seer and He knows very well what everybody does, and nothing will be escaping the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Qahhaar, comes from the strength and the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it's used in the Arabic language when someone does this to someone else, that means he defeated him, that he cannot do anything. So this is also something that is very clear with the attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, since all of the creation of Allah are under the power of Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above all, which also give the meanings of the superiority of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the most high, and everybody is underneath which, and everybody is subjected to the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So many of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they lead to one another. As we heard, that the believers, when they have this in their hearts, they have this tranquility in their hearts, the comfort in their hearts, that no matter what they see from human beings subjugating others, those who have wealth, power, and they abuse it. And we see this in the life of the Muslims today. Many of the Muslims are under means of oppression, means of injustices, and so on and so forth. The believers, they see that in their hearts, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above all, and they rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they only fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And it's meant to be this way for great reasons. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, whether it's because of the sins of the people, whether it's for the believers to be patient and to know the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth, that it happened to the nations before, to the prophets of Allah, to the believers, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to test them, to purify them this way, for them to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so on. So the believers, they know that this is by the wisdom of Allah. And instead of being busy looking at what human beings and terrified of what other human beings are doing, or worrying about them or fearing them, the believers, they refer and they rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and they witness the actions of Allah, that everything happens by the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His power. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, when he mentioned that the most tried people on the face of earth are the prophets and the like of them, so this is part of this life. This life is not what we like it to be based on our desires. It's all by the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fulfill the purpose that we have on it, and that is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And when we see that human beings are basically under this power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so the most tyrant of the tyrants, the most unjust person, that he oppresses others, he is under the power of Allah. Nobody can oppose the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the most wise. One of the things that we need to see in this is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He created the human beings, He ordered them to worship Him alone. That's why when we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should witness this. It's a great attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it's a sign of perfection, because the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are all perfect. But if a human being is given this attribute, it's something that is a weakness in the human being, something that is not good. But for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being the most merciful, being the most just subhanahu wa ta'ala, and being Al-Qahhaar, the subjugator, that nobody can do anything except by the permission of Allah. So when we look into the Quran, this is how we look into these names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We would see, for example, in Surah Al-Ra'd, verse number 16, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلِ اللَّهُ خَالِقُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَّارِ. That say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of all things, and He is al-wahid, al-qahhar. He is the only one. No one is the like of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is al-qahhar. He is the one that is the subjugator, that nobody can defeat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everybody is under the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because He's the creator of all things. He's the one that created the most oppressors of all oppressors. Fir'aun, what happened to him? He used to claim that he is the Lord of the Alameen. And he oppressed Bani Israel for many, many years. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we know what happened to Fir'aun and how he was under the power of Allah, and he was subjected to the power of Allah to the extent of which that the one that would destroy the kingdom of Fir'aun, which is Musa alayhi salam, was raised by Fir'aun himself. And we know the story of Musa alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have made the matter different, right? But it's made this way so that people would see clearly that no matter how powerful the person is, no matter how wealthy the person is and have all kinds of means to establish whatever he wants on the face of earth, nobody would say to him no. Nobody would refuse to apply his orders, and he has the means to fulfill whatever he wants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above all. He can destroy that person within his own same actions. That evil person would destroy himself with his own actions. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most high, the most wise subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is Al-Qahhaar. He's the one that subjugates those who are underneath Him and those who are basically weak creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The matter will be also made clear in the Day of Judgment when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say, لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَارِ. It will be said, who has the sovereignty on that day, meaning the Day of Judgment? Nobody would speak without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who's the one that has the real sovereignty in the Day of Judgment? And He's Malik Yawm al-Din. لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَارِ. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Wahid, the only one, Al-Qahhaar, the one that everybody is under the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is, as we see here, you know, this is something that a believer always remember, that no matter how much evil that a person see on the face of earth, everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The day, as we hear, as we see this in Surah Ghafir, that يَوْمَ هُمْ بَارِزُونَ لَا يَخْفَى عَلَى اللَّهِ مِنْهُمْ شَيْءٍ. That on that day, that when they would see, they would be all apparent, clear in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا يَخْفَى عَلَى اللَّهِ مِنْهُمْ شَيْءٍ. Nobody will be hidden, nothing will be hidden from them whatsoever, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, themselves, their actions, their intentions, their fear, their hope, whatever there is. لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ. The question will be mentioned then. To who is the sovereignty today? The kingdom is to who today? People, human beings, they used to claim things in this life, that they are the kings, they are the rulers, they can do whatever they want to do. And we see the arrogance in the speech of people sometimes. But then in the Day of Judgment, it would be said, لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ. To who have the kingdom and the sovereignty and the power on that day? Then the answer will come, لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَارِ. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Wahid, the only one. Nothing is the like of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Qahhaar, the subjugator, the one that is in charge of all things, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also in Surah Al-An'am, Surah Al-An'am is a beautiful surah that talks about the Tawheed, the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the entire surah is about the subject, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship. And that's why it's mentioned in Surah Al-An'am. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَهُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ وَيُرْسِلُ عَلَيْكُمْ حَفَظًا. Right, which is mentioned more than one time. وَهُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Qahir. And it's the same meaning with slight differences here. Al-Qahir فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the prevailing one over His creation. Right, that He is the one that prevails over His creation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, over all of them in general. Different than Al-Qahhaar. Al-Qahhaar is specific to those who are under the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Al-Qahhaar is more general. Al-Qahhaar is more in quantity of power and so on, and to specific individuals. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَهُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the prevailing one, فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ, over His creation. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most high. And وَيُرْسِلُ عَلَيْكُمْ حَفَظًا. He's the one that send hafada, angels, to protect you from harm, from things that might afflict you, But when the moment of death comes, of course, nobody can change the decree that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made. And that's why we have to be very clear on this. Nobody will die before his time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained for him. Whether a person die when he's young or old or whatever, it's all by the power of Allah. And we see that in the death of the human beings, how they are subjugated to the power of Allah. Nobody can push away the moment of his death for even one breath, one more breath. If the time comes, nobody can push that away. Even the most oppressors of all oppressors, the most powerful, the most wealthy, they cannot push away from them the moment of death. Right? And that's why even when a person is extremely sick, we have to be careful from saying certain words or having even some things in our hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best who's going to die when. When the time of death comes, nobody can push that away from the person whatsoever. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Qahhaar, and He is Al-Qahhaar, the one that everybody is subjugated under the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he used to say also this name in some of the dua that he would say alayhi salatu wasalam when he would wake up in the middle of the night, one of which is La ilaha illallah al-wahid al-qahhar Rabbu as-samawati wal-ardi wa ma baynahuma al-aziz wal-ghaffar. Whenever he would wake up at night, he used to say this: La ilaha illallah al-wahid al-qahhar. There is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-wahid al-qahhar, as it's mentioned in the verse al-wahid al-qahhar. And it's easy to memorize. You can memorize it now even. La ilaha illallah al-wahid al-qahhar. There is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-wahid al-qahhar, the only one, al-qahhar, the subjugator. Rabbu as-samawati wal-ard, the Rabb, the Lord of as-samawati wal-ard, of the heavens and the earth. Wama baynahuma, and what's between them. Al-aziz al-ghaffar, al-aziz, the almighty. And al-ghaffar, the most forgiving, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is something that when a person, as the hadith says, كَانَ إِذَا تَنَوَّرَ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ, that means the Prophet ﷺ, whenever he would change his position during the night, and as a result of that, he would wake up. You know, many times we would wake up in the middle of the night when we're moving, when we're going from one side to the other, right? It's a sign that the hearts are alive with the remembrance of Allah, that if a simple dhikr like this for a person to remember it, and there's other things also to be said, this is a great sign. And this is a blessing that a person would remember, to make remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at such times. So to say this and to mention this name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's one of the benefits of knowing this name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to say La ilaha illallah al-wahid al-qahhar, La rabbu as-samawati wal-ardi wa ma baynahuma al-aziz wal-ghaffar. Right? And this hadith in Sahih al-Jami', something for a person to say when he would wake up in the middle of the night. As we see that this subject of being oppressed, it's one of the most humiliating aspect of during this life that we live in. If someone is humiliated to the extent of which someone is subjugating himself by others to humiliate them, that's one of the worst things ever. And therefore, it's we see that as a way to get away from such a humiliation is to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being Al-Qahhaar. He's the one that is prevailing over all others. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala after the break and with your phone calls. So please stay tuned till we come back inshallah.
ضرب ابن مريم مثلا إذا قومك منه يصدون وقالوا أآلهتنا خير أم هو ما ضربوه لك إلا جدلا بل هم قوم خصمون
إن هو إلا عبد أنعمنا عليه وجعلناه مثلا لبني إسرائيل لو نشاء لجعلنا منكم ملائكة في الأرض يخلفون.
ما شاء الله. We have a young viewer. How old are you, Muhammad?
11.
ما شاء الله. Go ahead and recite from ayah number 10. فارتقب, please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فارتقب يوم تأتي السماء بدخان مبين. يا جنات هذا عذاب أليم. ربنا اكشف عنا العذاب إنا مؤمنون.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. فأسر بعبادي ليلا إنكم متبعون. واترك البحر رهوا إنهم جند مغرقون. كم تركوا من جنات وعيون ودروع ومقام كريم.
وتبارك الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض وما بينهما وعنده علم الساعة.
This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
We are on air again. Glad tidings to Hudda TV viewers worldwide for the resumption of live broadcasting on NowSat. We are now broadcasting on the advanced DVB-S2 system. Tune in using our new frequency, 12188 horizontal on NowSat. Please note, you will need to have a modern HD receiver in order to tune in. Enjoy your favorite edutainment programs with crystal clear resolution. Hudda TV, a light in every home.
Now that we know more about da'wah, what would you say are the characteristics of a da'i?
Sincerity.
Sincerity. Yes?
Good relation with Allah.
Good relation with Allah. Okay.
Patience.
Yes, sir?
Good manners.
Good manners. And there is much more to that. Join us in our program, the Da'wah Workshop, by your brother, Dr. Rayyan Fawzi Arab, so that we could talk more about da'wah exclusively on Hudda TV.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulullah. Welcome back, and we're talking about the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Qahhaar and Al-Qahir, and both have the same meaning, which means the subjugator, the one that nobody can defeat him, and everybody is under the power of Allah. Everybody is humble because everybody is the creation of Allah, and he's the one that defeated all of the oppressors. Those who oppress others, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will defeat them and would punish them and would humiliate them. And that's why it's something that is, again, a beautiful belief in the hearts of the believers, that everything is by the power of Allah, and that everybody will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the justice of Allah. And if people don't take their rights on the face of earth, then there's the day of judgment. where the most of the oppressors or the worst of the oppressors would wish then that they were humiliated on the face of earth and not to be among those who oppress others, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would humiliate them in the Day of Judgment. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he said that the arrogant ones, they will be like a dharr, like ants in the Day of Resurrection, where people will step on them and they will be humiliated in the Day of Judgment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned again this name in the Quran in many places. And Yusuf alayhi salam, he said that to the people with him in the prison, to invite them, to call them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship him alone, to show them that these things that they worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have no benefit whatsoever. They are creation of Allah. As Yusuf alayhi salam said to the people with him in the prison, as in verse number 39 in Surah Yusuf, يا صاحبي السجن أرباب متفرقون خير أم الله الواحد القهار. Such a beautiful question that gives only one answer, which makes the truth very clear to the people. Oh, my companions of the prison, and how he used this way of softening the hearts that are with him, that are together in this trial. Ya sahibai sijn, O companions of the prison, أَرْبَابُ مُتَفَرِّقُونَ. أَرْبَاب, lords that are scattered, right, that you worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Better, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَارِ, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the only one, the Qahhar, the subjugator that nobody can defeat whatsoever. Which one is better? To worship other lords and to worship other than Allah and idols and so on, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only one. Nothing is the like of him, and he is Al-Qahhar. And he showed to them that it's nothing but people invented names and things that they worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is basically, he's talking to who? To those who were oppressed in the prison, right? He's talking to them that they were oppressed by the oppressor of the one in charge, right? But Yusuf alayhi salam chose from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what fit their situation the best. He's talking to them while they're being in prison. Those who are in prison, they're under this humiliation. So he's reminding them, who's the one that is the one that everybody is under his power? He's the subjugator of all things, even the worst of the oppressors, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So why then worry about or having the hearts attached to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The hearts need to be attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Now, because of the time, we need to really focus after knowing the meaning of it and after having the proper belief in this, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Qahhar and he's the Al-Qahhar fawqa ibadi, that he is the one that is prevailing over his creation. Nobody can defeat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one that everybody subjugated to the power of Allah. Then how can we benefit from this name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our lives? We mentioned some of it when we were talking here, but here we need to make sure that we be in charge of our own selves by the will of Allah. We have in our own selves this tendency to be oppressors, to oppress others, whether to oppress our own selves when we follow our desires, whether to oppress others, those who are having less than us, whether it's wealth or authorities or whatever. So a person needs to humble oneself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By doing what? By asking Allah for forgiveness, by repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So our own self and egos and everything need to be subjected to this meaning, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above all. And no matter how powerful you are, right, it doesn't matter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can ruin oneself if a person is disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from sins and disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to basically oppress the shayateen and the devils, that they have no power whatsoever except to whisper. But the shaitan can have authority over the human being if the human being follow the ways of the shaitan. So we need to oppress these devils and these whispers by returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, by relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by seeking help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's how we, the people of Musa alayhi salam, the people of Bani Israel. Fir'aun, for example, he said to them, you know, when the people around Fir'aun, when they said to Fir'aun about Bani Israel, about Musa alayhi salam, atadharu Musa wa qawmahu liyufsidu fil ardi wa adharaka wa alihatak, you would leave Musa and his people to spread corruption on the face of earth and leave you and the things that you worship. Then Fir'aun said, he has the power, he has the wealth, he has the means to execute whatever he wants. He says, سَنُقَتِّلُ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ وَنَسْتَحْيِي نِسَاءَهُمْ وَإِنَّا فَوْقَهُمْ قَاهِرُونَ. He said, we'll kill their sons, we'll keep their women alive to serve us and so on. وَإِنَّا فَوْقَهُمْ قَاهِرُونَ. And we are above them, قَاهِرُونَ. He used the same word. We're above them, قَاهِرُونَ. We will defeat them, we will subject them to whatever we want them to be in. This is the words, this is the attitude of those who have this arrogant, right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that. But then look what Musa alayhi salam said to his people when this was mentioned by Fir'aun. The next verse, قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ إِسْتَعِينُوا بِاللَّهِ وَاصْبِرُوا. Right? Musa said to his people, right, إِسْتَعِينُوا بِاللَّهِ وَاصْبِرُوا, seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be patient. Why? إِنَّ الْأَرْضَ لِلَّهِ يُورِثُهَا مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ وَالْعَقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. That indeed al-ard, this earth, belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, does not belong to Fir'aun. The earth does not belong to nobody, does not belong to any nation, does not belong to any person. It belongs to Allah. He's the owner of all things. يُورِثُهَا مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ. He would inherit it to whoever he wills from his slaves. وَالْعَقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And the outcome is definitely for the muttaqeen, the people of taqwa, the obedient ones, those who fear Allah, those who are obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this ayah, and we need to look at it really, anyone that is weak and oppressed on the face of earth, this is the way to be established on the face of earth. Because the Quran is revealed to the Prophet ﷺ, showing the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times. Bani Israel were oppressed. When we see the situations of the Muslims today, they are weak and oppressed, right? By many on the face of earth. But alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. So here we learn from these verses, right? There is the like of Fir'aun, those who would say this, we will oppress them, we will so on and so forth. But then Musa alayhi salam said to his people, seek help from Allah. Do not act against the orders of Allah. Seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be patient. Be patient in applying the orders of Allah, because indeed the earth, nobody owns it. It's owned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that created it. And he would give it to whoever he wills from his slaves. And the outcome definitely is for the people of taqwa, for the people of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So clearly, seeking help from Allah, being patient, having the taqwa of Allah, these are the means to be established. These are the means for this ummah to be established, is to seek help from Allah, not to seek help from anyone but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because everything is under the control of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we really believe in the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why would a person seek help from other than Allah when everything is under the power of Allah? And to be patient with the deen of Allah, even if a person is oppressed or whatever there is, be patient with the deen of Allah, because the outcome definitely is for the believers, for the people of taqwa. So our job is to be among the muttaqeen. Our job is not to change the situation that we are in. Our job is to change ourselves and to enjoy good. And for believer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change our situation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade us from oppressing the orphans. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَمَّا الْيَتِيمَ فَلَا تَقْهَرْ. That for the orphan, do not make qahr on him, do not oppress him. The yatim, orphan, he lost his father before the age of puberty. And losing a father, the father is the strength, is the power, is the honor and dignity of a person. He goes after, you know, he protects his son or daughter and so on. So when they lose their father, then they become subjugated to the oppression from others. Whether it's a stepfather, whether it's someone that would, a relative or whatever there is. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering the believers to be careful, not to humiliate and to subjugate an orphan to all kinds of oppression, but rather to take care of the orphan, because he lost a great strength in his life. So this is something that a person should witness in one's life. never be an oppressor ourselves, because it's different levels, right? Being oppressing others, it might be an individual. It might be a husband towards his wife or towards his children, or someone at his work, whatever there is, a servant, whatever there is. So that's why a person should always remember this, so that we do things in matters of justice and goodness and so on. Also, as you know, many things is that when we see that pardoning instead of oppressing, pardoning others, forgiving one another, this is such a great meanings that need to be present in the lives of the people, right? When people would forgive one another and be kind to one another and so on. So really the matter here is very clear, that to benefit from this name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believing in it, is that the hearts of the believers are content. They have this tranquility in it and the comfort in it, that everything is by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So nobody can do anything except by the permission of Allah. And by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everybody, you know, will do whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decree for them. So why be terrified? Why do things in a sinful manner to protect oneself from harm and so on? Be patient with the orders of Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, he's the one that is above all. And to protect ourselves from falling into these evil attributes when it comes to the human beings. Some of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we heard before, we are ordered to do the like of it from the human perspective. For example, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving, we should forgive one another. So this is an attribute that is good for the human beings to have. But some of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's kamal and perfect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, since He's the creator of the heavens and the earth. But that same attribute, if it's from the human perspective, from a human to another human being, this can be not a good attribute. One of which is Al-Qahhaar or Al-Qahhir, when people would oppress one another, or they subjugate another to their own will. No, this is not a good thing for the human beings to have, but it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He oppresses who? Those who are oppressors, those who deserve to be punished. It is not for the righteous one, for the good ones in a negative way, but rather for those who deserve to be punished. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just subhanahu wa ta'ala. So nobody can also oppose the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a matter of belief, and this is how the person should see whether it's not defeating or not being defeated whatsoever. And it's important for us to go through the what is mentioned in the Quran about those who have power and tyranny and so on and so forth, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala treated them, the people of Ad, the people of Thamud, the Fir'aun, as we heard before, whatever there is, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them time, and He's the most forbearing subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they say whatever they say, and they suggest whatever they suggest, and they do all kinds of evil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them time, till when the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes, there's no point of return, and it shows the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this sultan, or this authority in our life, we should really choose to live it, that the authority and the sovereignty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over His creation matters of religion. That if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to pray 5 times a day, we say we listen and we obey, because He's Al-Qahhaar subhanahu wa ta'ala. If He leaves His slaves in this life to do whatever they want to do, but everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a serious matter to be obedient to Allah. And it shows in the lives of the believers when they believe in these names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they're willingly, they, you know, when someone is oppressed physically, a slave for example, and he is doing something, or say for example he's sitting with his friends, and his master or so, he ordered him at 4 o'clock exactly, he has to go to a specific place, otherwise, you know, the slave will be punished. What would that slave do when he's sitting with his friends or so? Right on time, he would leave. Why? Because he fears the punishment that he would receive, right? That's from a slave, from a human perspective, whatever there is. But when we think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that ordered us to worship Him, to bestow His mercy upon us, isn't it sufficient for the believers? They would leave everything and willingly surrender and submit themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regardless what people would say, what people would do. Because these individuals, those who would take us away from the obedience of Allah, they don't own anything. Who's the owner of all things? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that shows in the submission and the level of submission of the believers when it comes to the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So also when a person sees that the many verses that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Al-Wahid Al-Qahhaar, the Wahid, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one, and He is Al-Qahhaar, the one that subjugates everyone, and everybody is under the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How amazing it is that both are together in many verses, which is Al-Qahhaar and Al-Wahid. Why? Because He's the only one. Nothing is the like of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we see the creation of Allah, each one is being oppressed by the one that is above him. And everyone has some level of, you know, oppressing those who are underneath them. And it goes like this, and no one is the like of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So nothing is the like of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's why He is Al-Wahid Al-Qahhar. He's the only one in all of His names and attributes, and one of which is in this Qahr. Nobody can defeat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when people have this in their innate, right? Imam Sa'di rahimahullah, he said this in a beautiful statement. He says, كُلُّ مَخْلُوقٍ فَوْقَهُ مَخْلُوقٌ يَقْهَرُ. Every makhluq, every creation of Allah, He has another creation above Him, يَقْهَرُ. يَقْهَرُ oppresses Him, right? Make Him subjugated to His will. ثُمَّ فَوْقَ ذَلِكَ الْقَاهِرُ قَاهِرٌ أَعْلَى مِنْ. And above that oppressor, or above that person that has some power and authority, is Al-Qahir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, before that, it's another person that would oppress him. حَتَّى يَنْتَهِي الْقَهْر لِلْوَاحِدِ الْقَهْر. Till the Qahr, till this attribute of prevailing or so, reaches a level which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only one. Nothing is the like of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why he says, فَالْقَهْرُ وَالْتَوْحِيدُ مُتَلَازِمَانِ. That Al-Qahr and the Tawheed, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship, mutalaziman, they cannot be separated. Muta'ayyanani lillahi wahdahu. They are really only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are specific to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are unique to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So there is no way for a person to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and to really establish the Tawheed and the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the purpose of our life, unless they see this in their hearts, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Qahhar. He's the one that is above all. He's the one that defeats everyone. Nobody can defeat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody can do anything against the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's why it's something that is very strong related to the matter of the Tawheed, the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, when people start questioning the diseases and the sickness of the children and their death and the oppression on the face of earth and so on, right? It doesn't mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is punishing them. This is the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? And He's the most wise subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing happens except by the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not just by the qahr of Allah, by the power of Allah, but it's also by the wisdom of Allah, by the knowledge of Allah, by the mercy of Allah, right? So this is how then things will be, and this is how those who oppress others, they will return to the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those who were oppressed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them the best of the reward, that they would wish even that they were even oppressed more and more. But of course, the person should never ask for such a thing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one, and He is the one that everybody is under His power, and no one can defeat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one can oppose the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Have the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He's the most merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala, and be obedient to Him, be patient till everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the outcome definitely is best for the muttaqeen, for the people of taqwa, for the believers, for those who understand these meanings and are patient. Don't be in haste. Don't think that this is the end of the world. or the end of, sometimes a person face difficulty in money situations, for example, or looking at of the affairs of the Muslims and so on, they think that's the end of it. That's bad expectations of Allah. No, the matter is not like this. Things will get better, inshallah ta'ala. It's all by the power of Allah. If we return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and for the believers, all of their affairs is good for them, because they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Wahid Al-Qahhaar, the only one, the one that is above all. To turn to Him alone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change our situation. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us benefit from what we hear, and to make us among those who perfect their tawheed, and to change our situation, and to purify our hearts, and to make us among those who purify their hearts with the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for all of us, and to keep us steadfast on the deen of Allah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wa salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Change your heart, Lord, change our heart. You're living in a lawful way. Be mindful of what you say. Be sincere when you pray. Today could be your last day. Bear each other no malice. Greed and faith can coexist in the same heart. Change your heart.